praise God. Amen. We praise and bless the Lord this morning. Come on, everybody say hallelujah. Come on, just say hallelujah. Amen. He just said, I was glad when he said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. How many glad to be in the house of the Lord today? Amen. I'm glad to be here. I'm glad that I know, amen, why I'm here. I'm here to glorify and worship my God. Amen. I'm here to glorify and worship the Lord God. It's been good. Has it been good to you? Amen. Has it been really good to you? Oh, praise the Lord. Amen. We thank God today. We welcome you. Those of you in our sanctuary this morning, we're so glad to see your faces. Amen. To hear your voices. Amen. Amen. It's good to see you this morning. And we're grateful for those that couldn't make it. And you tuned in at home on the virtual audience and platform, wherever you might be this morning. We are just grateful. Amen. Grateful to have you with us this morning. Come on, say hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I'm so glad. So glad that he is a God that we can worship. Amen. The only God that I would worship. The only God that I want to give my praises to. Amen. Amen. I thank God for that today. Amen. Let us stand to our feet. Amen. As we fight the presence of God, amen, we can continue to be in our midst this morning. We're two or three gathered together. Amen. He said, I'll be there in the midst. So, amen. So we praise God for that. Amen. Let's just quote the Lord. Father, we thank you for the privilege to be in the house of the Lord this morning. Have your way this morning, Lord God. Let the will of God be done. As we continue to be exalted, and we continue to humble ourselves, God be praised and be exalted and magnified, we pray. And we bless you and praise you now, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Together as we're led to worship by our ministry to lead know, the DJ, and as I was having my quiet,
let everything that hath breath and everything that hath breath. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Don't matter how it looks now.
Hallelujah. In the presence of my enemies. In the presence, I raise a hallelujah. Louder than the other, I raise a hallelujah. It is my weapon is my weapon, it is my weapon. Oh, I raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me. Come on, I want to hear y'all sing. I'm going to sing. I'm going to sing. In the middle of the storm, louder and louder, you're gonna hear my praises roar. And up from the ashes, hope will arise. Death is defeated, the King is alive. Hallelujah! I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm. Spoke the words that there be light, and there was. And in that same breath, the sword fell in line with one voice, creation cries, you do all things well. Oh, you do all things well. So be praised. Be praised forever and always. Lost in the dark, upon the dirt, I was buried, left to die. But I heard your voice calling my name. From the womb to my came alive. You do all things well. Oh, you do all things well. So be praised, oh, be praised, be praised, be praised, be praised. You spoke those words, let there be light, and there was. And in that same breath, the sun fell in line, with one voice, creation cried, you do all things well. One voice, creation cried, you do all things well. Come on, say, so be praised. Be praised. Come on, church. Be praised. Lord, you be. Be praised. Lord, be praised. Be praised. Be praised. Be praised. Forever and always. Forever and always. Lost in the dark, up under the dirt, I was very glad to die. But I heard your voice calling my name. From the tomb I came alive. You do all things well. From the tomb I came alive. You do all things well. Come on, sing it, church. So be praised. Be praised, Lord, be praised, be praised, be praised, be praised, be praised, be praised, forever and always, forever and always. Not the end of all you've done, and all the battles you've brought. Praise, oh, be praised.
Thank you. You promised to perfect those things, O God, which concerneth me. The things I present to you, you can perfect those things. The things I hold on to, you can perfect those things. So today,
today is my day. The day I receive from the hand of the Lord. Today I exchange heaviness. Oh God, today I put down the garment of heaviness. I give it over to you. I finally give it over to you, God, and I put on the garment of praise. Oh, Togo, many years I've been carrying burdens, but today, today you'll be glorified in me. Today you'll be glorified in me. So when I leave here, you can be glorified in my home. You can be glorified on my job. You can be glorified wherever I am, God. Help us to trust you. Help us to believe. Help us to receive from you today what you have for us. This is the day that the Lord has made for me. And I will rejoice with it.
Sister Mika, Sister Bob, I'm here. She's going to be so other hands, and I want to ask you to continue to anoint these young women. Any others of our dancers here? I'm missing them because I can't see them. What a ministry this is as they offer their bodies to minister and dance. Pray that the Lord will keep their bodies. Pray that the Lord will fill them so they will be produced. So that in addition to new skill and new detail and new dedication, they'll have a become full anointing. We pray in the name of Jesus that His great glory will be seen. We pray, young women, leader and dancers, that God will do a great and a new thing through the choreography, a great and a new thing through the dance ministry, that people will be healed and blessed, that people will be changed and strengthened, that people will be transformed as they witness the dance of the world. The minister, will you come and stand behind these young girls as the Hamptons dance behind her former dance to the rest of all right. Glory to God. Y'all stretch your hands. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for the glory that filled the house. As we play around the dance before you, we had a chance to receive a download what you put in Sister Mika James' spirit. Hallelujah. We pray for Sister Mika James' spirit that it would be filled with the Holy Spirit and that you continue to inspire her heart, her mind, her skin, her imagination, so that every round will go higher and higher, and rather than feeling pressure, she'll feel inspired. In Jesus' name, to lead the people, we pray for the health and the strength of her body. And we pray, we set ourselves in agreement and pray for whatever things that are happening on her heart. Lord, we pray that you will move mightily, that you will answer her questions, and that you will answer her prayers. Hallelujah, that you will fill her full of yourself. Oh God, that you order her steps, that you give her great favor going, coming, sitting, standing, driving, sleeping, the favor of God at work and at home, resting on me, that you give the favor of God the Father, the blood of Jesus the Son, the indwelling Spirit, hallelujah, of the Holy Ghost in our precious leader here, in Jesus' name, to this angel whose name is Micaiah. We ask great blessing that the spirit of Esther has already been pronounced. That you send her for such a time as this, that she would lead her people. We pray, O God, that we would help to pour into her so she'll be greatly nourished for the season in which she's called upon to lead. That she would use not just her gift of dance, but her brilliant mind and her wonderful capacity to articulate, that you would be glorified. Every chapter of Micaiah's life, pray the blood of Jesus over her, sitting, standing, going, coming, in home and outside, at school, and on her way, at dance. We pray the blood of Jesus and the angels of the Lord. To Father Layla, we give you thanks and praise for her ready mind, her willing heart. Hallelujah! Fill Layla with your Holy Spirit and bless all the work that her hands do. These ideas, oh God, that you give her, bless them with favor and support. Hallelujah. We pray that she'd be encouraged and built up in her inner being, that she'd be baptized in the Holy Ghost. Oh God, that everything that the devil plans for Layla's life will come crashing into defeat. And that the plans that God has might come to full fruition. We pray for our daughters today, for the will of God to be done in their lives. In the name of Jesus, we give you thanks and praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, let's put our hands together and thank God for them again.
Oh my friends, I can't.
lift our hearts, sing it up. Come on, let your hearts sing, heart, sing it up. Lift. Oh, and I know it's not much. I'm the female to forgive. Step for a heart, sing it. A heart, sing it, hallelujah. All the earth will shout your praise. My heart will cry, these bones will say, great are you, Lord. And all the earth will shout your praise. My heart will cry, these bones will say, great are you, Lord.
Degree, or maybe a master's degree, if you had completed a degree. Now listen, everybody who didn't complete a degree will be able to say, oh boy, that's no joke. But I want to ask you, have you completed a degree? Because you raised your children and your family's children. And as you work full time, and as you cared for a home, and as you cared for relatives who needed your covering, I want to ask you to put your hands together and give God thanks, because Ashley Tonto earned a master's degree. She earned it. She earned it. She earned it. She earned it. She cooked breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and she earned it. She went to work and then went to school. She earned it. She's a wife to her husband, and a mother to her daughters, and a mother to her niece, and a mother to her caseload. Come on, somebody. And she still earned it, Ashley. We're proud. Amen. We call you Master Ashley today. Because you earned that master's degree, baby. We're proud of you. Amen. We give God thanks and praise for our loved ones. I'm so glad to see Sister Tiffany Lewis. You're looking beautiful. And to see our wonderful Casey Walter. Just stand and wave to us, Casey. Amen. Yeah, when y'all see her in the WNBA, don't say you didn't know her because you said, oh, that was our Casey. Casey is brilliant and talented. So glad that Sister Florence Ford is back home safely. Welcome home. So glad that Sister Renee Cross is home safely. Welcome home. We miss our family when they go. So glad to see her back home. You tell your neighbor, I'm glad to be in the house of the Lord. I'm glad to be sitting here right next to you. That's right. My friend Sean is our Sean. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So glad to see you all. So glad for Sister Tiara from college, a graduate. When you met her, she was in high school, but she's a college graduate. We give glory to God. So friends, we have a triune God. The root word for triune is what? Tri, which means what? Three. We have a God who is one God in three persons. So in the Old Testament, our triune God was mostly known as God the Father, isn't that right? And then in the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, we get to see God manifested as a The Son is Jesus. Sermon and received a significant response. And when this came to the Lord, me to commit it, and I have not repented just once. You know why? Because I haven't sinned just once. Amen. Repentance is an acknowledgement of wrong. An acknowledgement and agreeing with God's righteousness. If I acknowledge that my actions are wrong when I repent, when I agree with the righteousness of God, I say, Lord, your ways are not my ways. But I didn't get this thing right, and I agree that your ways are right. And then I turn away. Tell you, David, that's the part that counts. You got to turn away. You got to turn away. You got to turn away. And sometimes we have to turn away from people who don't turn away from behaviors. Somebody dislocates your chin. I don't want to punch. And then they say, oh my goodness, I'm sorry. That's terrible. Well, I should have done that. Forgive me. It's Tuesday. They black your eye. Now you have to turn away. How many people know I'm right about that? Now you got to turn away. If they don't go turn, you have to turn. Somebody got to turn. Say it funny, but it's not funny, isn't it? First, you have to repent, and then you have to be baptized. Baptism is this immersion in water. It's not to wash up, take a shower. It's not a quick sponge bath, a herb bath like your grandmother used to. It is a symbol of a believer's identification with the death, the burial, the bodily resurrection of Jesus Christ. He says you have to repent. That's the first. You have to be baptized. That's the second. The gospel writer says that the one who believes and is baptized shall be saved. And finally, he said, you shall be filled God with the gift of the Holy Spirit. You shall be filled. So the first part, the formula of the scripture for Pentecost is repentance, baptism, and the indwelling of the Spirit. Following that description caused the church to grow mightily in a short period of time. The Pentecost experience came with a prescription, but it was also expressed by the power of Jesus. Power was behind the sound of the rushing, raging wind that the disciples heard as they sat praying to God in the upper room. Power was behind it. Power was the source of the flames of fire they saw resting over each of their heads. Power was the catalyst for the disciples' ability to speak languages they never learned before. Power motivated Peter to preach an impromptu sermon in which 3,000 souls were spared. They repented, were baptized, and they began to follow Jesus all in one year. The band of disciples became the church because power was exercised. Pentecost was experienced. What was the source of this power? It was the Holy Spirit. Before Jesus was crucified, he told his disciples that when he went away, the Father was going to send him to counselor, an advocate, an ally, a paraclete. Somebody's coming in my place. And then he said, with a finger, he said, it's advantageous for you. It's to your good that I go. They said, what would you be talking about? How would it be good for us that you go? The Messiah, he said, believe it or not, God has something that's going to give you an advantage. The Father is going to send you comforter, counselor, advocate, paraclete in my name, and he won't just be with you like I'm with you. He's going to be what? In you. Oh my goodness. And so Jesus says that God, the Father, is going to send him in his name, and he says to them, I'm ending my earthly ministry, but I promise that you'll be comforted. You'll be with you forever. Somebody leave you. You still have the comforter. Somebody cut you off. Walk away. You yet have your comforter. Somebody doesn't want to talk to you like they used to want to talk to you. Okay. Because I have one who promised never to leave me. Never to leave me alone. Then in John 16, Jesus explains that it was beneficial for them. Because his departure from earth signifies
Let's go,
because the body was yielding to hold on in. Oh, Lord, you felt so sorry for him as you pounded your chest, trying to get the water, trying to get up oxygen and health enough resuscitation, and he draggled and went in half dead. Thank you. results were made, they began to speak languages they had never learned, they had never studied, and to tell them what it was first done. And this event changed the course of human history. We're here today in the church because a band of 120 disciples became the church. You know, the catalyst was for them becoming the church, the Holy Ghost, coming to indwell the believers in the open world. When they began to speak those languages, I want to say to you that there as good a present that it was. My uncle won by diligence, thank God for all of them. Does somebody thank God for all of them? Uncle won by his family. Is that all you want? Now, here's a question I keep asking. Really? Uncle's question to me is my question to you. Is that all you want? This moment is all right for you. Can't pray away no headache. That's all you want. Somebody don't speak. You stay out of church 3 weeks. Is that all you want? Don't you need more power than that? Don't you need more power than that? Don't you need more than that? Don't you want some more? Don't you want some more than that? Baby, that's all you want. It's not my fault. Oh, it's just all there is. It's a collapse. We walk back to the kitchen. It's quite so nice. Push. So they had an upper oven and an lower oven. Hallelujah. Tell the neighbor the upper and the lower. Glory to God. Uncle opened up the upper oven. There was a whole can of macaroni and cheese. In the lower was a container of collard greens. A pound of fresh cornbread, I tell you, they were pouring bread. And a whole tray of chicken. He said, sweetheart, there's much. That's what I came to tell you tonight. There isn't a little more. There's much. If you live on a little bit, it's because that's all you want. If you live on a little bit and you struggle for the next 15 years of your life, it'll be because you chose not to access more.
Yesterday, got me at this place, but I can't get to the next place with this little bit. What am I doing?
get your phone ready. You see whose name is on you. Tell me. If I can bring a moment back, it may help you not to call back at all. And maybe they help you call back. I'm good with these four names. You see what I mean? This is what I mean. Now, come on, this is me. Please help me. You shall receive him. When the Holy Ghost comes to you. You have to release. You have to release. You have to release. Divine intervention is just given. Counsel with your own thoughts. You make decisions with your own twisted emotions. Been twisted since you was in the fourth grade. You're going to use that twisted mess of emotions to make valuable, huge, consequential decisions about your life. Is that your heart? Is that your situation? Is that your spirit? Your team don't have to be on you.
Yeah.
our hearts. Come and fill us up. Every empty place, every dry place, every desolate place, come live in us, we pray in Jesus' name. If you're here today, have not come to know Jesus the Christ, whose word is a lamp to your feet and a light to your path, we invite you to come. The healer of broken hearts is here. The mend of broken hearts is here. The mender of broken hearts is here. The mender of broken lives is here. The weaver of dreams and destinies is here. We're here. Come and meet him because he's here. If you want to just ask the church to pray for you this week because you need to be filled with the Holy Spirit, you just wave your hand. You don't have to get up just with, yeah, I want to be filled. I need to be filled. I've got some empty places. I need to be filled, filled, filled. I see you, my sister. Amen. I need to be filled. I see you, my brother. I need to be filled. You got some empty spots. I can tell I'm dry. Hey, now my whole show. Jesus, have your way. Hallelujah. In my life, in my mind, in my will, and in my spirit. That is the kingdom and the power and the glory for you. In Jesus' name, if you would like to join our church and be a member, we invite you to come down. That's the date that you return now from here. Our service is going to come in. We give God praise and glory. Anybody here who said this feels like home to me? Amen. We don't have much. Oh, we might have some chocolate chip cookies today, actually. Amen. We have some for you. Unless you have to go with your peace of Christ, coffee hours, and then you have to go to announcements. Please don't leave. Please don't go to the cafe yet.
Good morning, fellowship. Here are your weekly announcements. We will have open prayer via teleconference every Saturday evening at 8 p.m. The fellowship food pantry is open to serve the community every Wednesday from 9 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. And if you are a member of fellowship and you need a food from the pantry, please get people to Teresa Robinson or anyone from the food pantry team to receive your items on Sunday instead of waiting for Wednesday. The Hungry Hands Ministry continues to serve hot meals to the community every first and third Saturday of the month. If you are someone you know is in need, please stop by between 12 p.m. and 2 p.m. to receive a meal and a to-go container. Please join us for Bible study on Wednesdays at 7 p.m. via YouTube, where we will focus on the Gospels. The Prime Times program, sponsored by the Congregation of Care Ministry, is for women 80 and above and includes opportunities to share meals, testimonies, encouragement, and fun. If you are a Prime Timer, reserve the last Tuesday of every month from 12 to 2 p.m. for these meaningful gatherings, and be sure to RSVP with a member of the Congregation of Care Ministry. Please note that starting June 1st, office hours will pass to meet from Wednesday through Sunday. The Abundant Life Ministry presents Food Prep with Sister Keisha Smithwick on Saturday, June 15th from 12 noon to 2 p.m. As we continue working on a healthy lifestyle, Coach Keisha will demonstrate smart and healthy ways to prepare our food. We are asking for a donation of $10 to attend, and we'll raffle off an air fryer on the day of the event. So please see Sister Lynn Brown, Nurse Tools Clinton, or Sister Lucette Clark to purchase your tickets and raffles. The Hungry Hands Ministry is hosting a night of karaoke at Fellowship Covenant Church on Saturday, June 22nd, from 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Come and sing your heart out to just cheer on a friend while enjoying food, fun, and laughter. The cost to attend is $20, so please see Sister Krista Baker Barnes for more details on this fun-filled event. Please be advised, church family, that on Sunday, July 28th, we will have an in-person FCC meeting immediately following service. Please register by emailing ship720@gmail.com. We'd love to have you worship with us in our beautiful sanctuary here at Fellowship Covenant Church, where the love is. Ladies, be advised, church family, that temperature tests will be taken at both entrances. And if your temperature is higher than normal, you'll be asked to worship virtually. fellowship with us online and in YouTube so we can continue to be a safe environment for you.
Thank you for worshiping with us.
If you'd like more information on anything you've heard here today, we invite you to connect with us online at fellowshipcovenant.church. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook. Those are our announcements. Have a blessed week.
Yeah. Forever and ever, all God's people said, amen.